Welcome back to Don't Starve. This is Rantry, and we are here with Wilson, and our umbrella is just deteriorating because I'm holding it when I'm not supposed to be. Let's eat us up a bacon and eggs, and let's make us up maybe a couple of bacon and eggs. So, the plan, as always, is to have a plan. So, last episode I was talking about getting some gold and feeding monster meat to the Pig King, which, I already took a bunch of monster meat, which you can't do. And the reason I was confused about that, or I had related monster meat and the Pig King in my mind, was that if you cook monster meat and then give it to the bird, it will give you eggs, and the Pig King will give you gold for eggs. So I'm going to drop off a few things in our basic resource chest. And like I said, the plan is to have a plan. That's the wrong button. That's caps locks. I want tab. So I need to get some gold to make some more flingos. To make some more doodads for my flingos, which will be going in here to complete my fire farm. That's kind of the long-term, well, mid-term, short-term, whatever goal. But I do need to get some gold, and so I'm going to take some monster meat, cook it, give it to the bird, get some eggs, go to the Pig King, get some gold. But I thought while I'm going to the Pig King expressly, I might as well go down here and dig up all these graves while I can, and gather my rosebuds while I may. So instead of crafting a whole bunch of, is this our miscellaneous chest? Yes. The doodad and the gears can go in there for now. I'm going to go ahead and cook this up just while I'm here. But just while I have the chance, my plan is to go down, dig the graves, come back through here, get the old bell, go up, give the trinkets I get from digging graves and possibly some monster meat to the Pig King. But I should get enough trinkets from digging graves that I can actually just use all of these eggs for actual food. Anyways, and let's see, pick up my hammer on the way when I'm coming back here. Oh, yeah. I'm attempting to organize my business. And let's take one of the bacon and eggs with us just for fun. And, so the plan is to, get gold from the Pig King, but as I go up there, I'm gonna continue walking and check on my tree farm. I don't want to jump through the wormhole, because I could get trapped right here, and while I'm up here, see if the moose goose has laid an egg, hammer down the egg, and, 67%, 84%, we can leave this one. Hammer down the egg, kill the moose goose. You know what? I'm actually going to... Well, I'll be coming back by my base before I head up there. Right now, the first step is to go down and dig a bunch of graves. And I'm actually, even though I need gold, I'm going to use... Did I use all of my gold? Yes, I did. I'm going to... I don't need all these rocks. I'm going to make a shovel to dig graves. I'm just gonna make a regular shovel because I don't have the gold for a regal one. And we're just gonna head on down south here to the graveyard. So that's the general plan. Day 45. So day 45 we'll be digging graves and heading back to the base. And then day 46 slash the end of 45 we'll be giving things to the Pig King to get gold and going up to check on our trees and killing moose goose and possibly the egg as well. So I cannot forget to get my old bell when I run back by my base. I tell that to myself, and yet I very well may. All right, Jim, nope. Problem, not amazing. All right, there we go. That's what I want, is some of these trinkets. Voodoo doll is actually somewhat of a rare. Let's see, there were two over there. There's one down here. I'm going to just kind of open up this way. And they digging these graves does hurt your sanity. And it looks like the graveyard probably ends. Yeah, this is kind of the main area of the graveyard. But it does hurt your sanity. And I'm not really too worried about my wetness right now. I may be able to dig most, if not all of these before the end of the night. I'm wearing my Tam O'Shanter to recover some sanity as I dig these up. All right, there's a ghost. I don't particularly want to mess with the ghost, so I won't. I'll just kind of run away from him and let him hang out down here. Now we may, I know it's almost a cliche and don't starve at this point, but we may just keep the gnome to be our little housewarming pet and leave him by the front door of our estate. All right, is that all of the graves? There's one more right here, but I did get a few trinkets. That's another one, and you can get some. I don't know if you'd call them rare, but you can get some semi-rare trinkets from digging these graves. Usually the ones you get from farming tumbleweeds are different. But we've dug up all the graves. We're almost insane. And if I were a different character, I would say this would be a great time to go get some beard lords or some beardlings, or do whatever you need to do to get beard hair. Because you need to be insane to do that. That's still a tier 1. Spiders, you can just hang out. If you need beard hair, go insane and kill rabbits is the long and the short of it. Let's go ahead and equip our umbrella. Alright, so I've got my trinkets. This should get me, and I don't know the entire, well, basically, I don't know, where'd my burn bag go? I don't know exactly how much each trinket gives you. They seem to have different amounts. We're gonna warm up a little bit. We may go ahead and shave our beard now. It's getting on to be a little bit warmer, so we'll go ahead and do that. And the only thing I ever use beard hair for, I think, is meat effigies. So we're going to go ahead and categorize that under the magical tab. I'm going to take these wings. I'm going to take that old bell. I'm going to switch it out for that. And let's see. Oh, yeah, we got a bunch of gems as well. So open our magic chest. Our gems can go in there. And then our old bell can go in here. And we can just drop off Glommer's wings up here to remind us to take them up to his shrine, because we will be having way too many of those. We'll put on the Tam O'Shanter. I may want to be making... Yeah, we'll switch out our bags. Glommer, come up here a little closer to the fire, bud, if you don't mind. Just regain some of that sanity overnight by hanging out next to Glommer and wearing our Tam O'Shanter. And making sure we stay a little bit dry. And then, let's see, do I need to... Let's see, I'm going to have one gold. We will leave the gnome just to be our little mascot. But these trinkets, I've got that one, I've got that one, and I've got these two. Should be enough. We can drop off this pitchfork. I don't know why I'm carrying it around. We are going to face Moose Goose, so I'm going to get a couple of pairs of new armor. And let's see. I might swing by the swamp and see if I can get a tentacle spike as well. So, yeah, everything's fine. My hunger's a little bad. We'll go ahead and eat up our bacon and eggs. And we'll go ahead and take that other one that we made right there. And we will head out toward, and I'm going to go ahead and put on a football helmet just to stay completely dry. And I'm going to pick some flowers just to get my sanity up so I don't hear all the crazed voodoo talking. So we'll get our sanity up a little bit. I could go ahead and wear the tam, but that will mean that my my wetness will be going up, but not too worried about that right now. Okay, great. Some more rotten eggs. That will give us the ability to make gunpowder in the summer. And then after we take care of Moose Goose and we take care of our fire farm, we will be the big priority will be to get our summer base set up before summer actually hits. All right, yeah, he's gonna give us tons of gold. All right, there's all our trinkets, and we'll just pick up all this gold, and then we'll head on up to Moose Goose. Now, you know what? The other thing I wanted to do, in case I screw up and get the Moslings, I think, oh, I missed one gold. Okay, good. We can take off our umbrella. I believe that I will be able to kill all of the Moslings in one fell swoop with the old bell. Let's get all of our essentials on our person. Flint is probably not going to be an essential right now. The shovel will also not be an essential. Oh, I wanted to swing by the swamp. I am going to swing by the swamp just to see if there might be a stray tentacle spike laying around. It would be a little bit better than a 45% spear, and I don't want to have to make another spear. Yeah, there's one right there. I had a feeling that there might be some tentacle spikes lying around. And indeed there was. We could kill us some pigs, but no real reason to do that. Merm, you chill. All right, this is gonna be, yep, this is gonna be interesting. There are two tentacle spikes up here. Bap and bap. And you guys can just, you know what? You guys can, I don't care about one pig skin, really. Not really worth the risk, but I did get two tentacle spikes, which is great. At some point, once we get the fire farm up, it'll be ham bats all the way. But for now, tentacle spike will certainly have to do. And now I'm tempted to just drop this 45% spear, but I'll keep it on me for the time being. And yeah, we'll head up here. We'll see if we can find a Moose Goose egg. But I think first we're going to go check out our trees. So I'm going to give Moose Goose a little bit of a wide berth as I walk up here. Of course, you know, she wanders around. I don't know where she might be. You know what? It's high time we hammered this stupid thing down. Get a few little resources there. Get another sapling. Sure, I can drop that at any time. And there's actually some more graves up here. And if my sanity climbs, which it might, especially if I... You know what, we're going to replant this sapling just to get it out of our inventory. And I may make a fire up here tonight, which is why I am picking these green caps. Yeah, okay, there's Moose Goose. See if we can maybe see... Where's my walking cane? We can maybe see an egg anywhere, Moose Goose. Yeah, you're honky. You're honky. I don't want her to follow me up here, so I'm gonna prioritize checking on my trees. I'm not exactly sure how long trees take to grow to full maturity like this. And they are almost there. In fact, if we camp out tonight, they may be there in the morning. So I could go try and kill Moose Goose now. I don't really want to do that. I could dig graves. Yeah, it's gonna be... Well, if Moose Goose hasn't laid an egg, there's... I don't want to kill her yet. So we need to probably go explore around for Moosey's egg. And it does not look like does not look like she has laid an egg yet. And I want the egg for... The Moslings are very dangerous, but I want the egg for the down feathers. And I thought she laid one on every, like, 4 days or something. But I could certainly be wrong. You know, if you leave her... Usually, when Moose Goose appears, if you leave her alone for a few days, she'll lay an egg. And if you kill the Moslings in the egg, you get a lot of down feathers. Okay, we're going to come back here on day 47. But right now, it's not quite ready for us. So we will go ahead back down and continue our fire farm. And we have plenty of gold for our fire farm. Whether we have enough grass or not is a different story. I may have to go farm grass over here and just dig all this stuff up and bring it back to my base. Probably a better idea might be to go down here and farm up a whole bunch of grass. And then at the same time, I could dig up some of this carpet and stuff. I want to expand my kitchen and my base as well. But to do that, I need to kind of see certain types. If this makes sense, I want to try and get it centered. Get the kitchen kind of centered. And I didn't place things right in there. And I don't want to waste them by hammering them down. So I may have to kind of get fiddly with the turf. Yeah, there's a suspicious dirt pile. Once we have this fire farm up and running, we'll basically never have to worry about food again, and then we can worry about drying racks and things like that. But, for now, the general plan... So here's my kitchen, and you can see that This ice box is not quite centered, and these crock pots are not quite centered on this thing. So I'm gonna do a little experiment. If it were a gum flavor, it might be experiment. I'm gonna dig up one of my carpets here and place it over yonder. Okay, that does go onto the crock pot. And I'm gonna dig up one of my checkered floorings. And I'm gonna place it... well, let's just see what it looks like here. Yeah. So another checkered flooring. Well, this is kind of what I want, because then this crock pot looks centered on that checkered flooring. I do have my crock pots overlapping a little bit onto the... What does wood... I'm not 100% certain of the turf priorities. No, not that. Pick up the wooden flooring. So I'm not sure if wooden flooring goes under both carpet and... let's place it there. Okay, so it looks like it goes over top of checkered flooring and underneath. Let's go ahead and eat up our bacon and eggs. And underneath carpet. So I think that if I make this whole area checkered, but leave this part grass, I'm gonna dig up another checkered flooring. And this is just me being anal about kind of how the base looks. Oh, come on. Place ground. I forgot to right click. Okay, if that becomes the square, then this is kind of centered. So I think that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to do carpet, and maybe even more. I might extend this carpet all the way down here, or I might do wood flooring. I'm not sure. At any rate, that's all I wanted to check out. For now, let us grab our ice. Oh yeah, I'm overloaded. Let's go ahead and make some. We'll just use these berries to make bacon and eggs. Oh, I'm sorry, meatballs, and we'll stick these in there, and then we should have enough for our ice. Okay. Drop off that tool. We'll drop off. Or we'll stick our wooden flooring back down. We can stick our old bell back in here as long as I don't forget it next time. and stick one tentacle spike there and the spear there. I'm going to hang on to this other tentacle spike for now. And let's see, we aren't going to need that immediately. And I did burn my other log suit, so we'll keep that on us. And that can go in there. Basically, every time I come back to base, I like to tidy up the place. Our pitchfork can stay here for now. I don't think I'm going to get to digging any. Yeah, just drop it, buddy. I don't think I'm going to get to any. And our hammer can go back here. Just like to try and keep my inventory as clean as possible. And I click drop, and then he doesn't seem to drop it. All right, let's do the fire farm here. I'm gonna want to get. Oh, good. We've got a lure plant. And you just kind of carve a path through the eyeballs to get to the lure plant, and that's all. Oh crap! I do need my pitchfork because I want to actually make this 4x2 instead of 3x2. I think, and I think the flingos should absolutely cover that. And I've already got one pre-made. Yes, I do. All right, and I guess I'll pick up my grass while I'm here. Not that I will probably even have enough. And let's go ahead and prototype our hay wall. There we go. Oh, I forgot that you needed twigs for that as well. All right, we'll get some twigs. Do we have any more twigs? Our farms have grown. All right, I'm gonna... some people have been saying, you know, hey, you should cut out some of the boring parts that are kind of grindy, like picking all these twigs, and then right after this, I'm going to pick all that grass in my farms. But I know I said, you know, I plan on leaving every painful, grindy moment in this Let's Play, because when I did the Shipwrecked Let's Plays before, people were saying, hey, don't cut stuff out, you know, we want to see everything, and I was like, really? You know, but I may cut this farming out, because I'm literally just holding spacebar and gathering twigs, and then I will be gathering a whole bunch of grass. So I very well may cut this part out. Alright, so I finished farming up all the twigs and grass in my little farms, and now I'm almost ready to go ahead and build my fire farm. Do we have any more space in the fridge? Yes, we do. Okay, let's see. We can drop off our logs. Drop off our fez. And yeah, I'm gonna actually need that cut stone. The steens. Because we need to, and oh yes, and the doodad. Where did I stick the doodad? Probably in the, yep. Right there in the miscellaneous chest. So we're gonna need three flingos, so we're gonna need six doodads. So go ahead and make those up right now. And we got one cut stone left over. And actually we can go ahead and stick our excess gold in here too, because now we are done with that. I do have a torch in my inventory I can go ahead and let burn out. And we'll go over and start placing. Well, first we'll dig our the space that we want for our fire farm, because I do want to extend it one more this way. And there goes the torch. Pick up the turf. And one more. All right, now we are set to place our flingos. So we want to stick them kind of in the corners here. So we'll stick one there. All right, that's more or less in the corner. I'm going to try and place these equidistant from each other. Oh, crap. I knew I'd forget something. I forgot the, I'm wearing the football helmet again because of the water, the rain protection. I knew I'd forget something, and I forgot my gears. Let's grab those up. I'm not exactly sure how many I'll need, but, you know, they take up a stack anyways. This leafy meat I don't care about if it spoils. But now we can make another flingo. We're going to need 4 flingos. And I want to make sure I kind of keep it... I want to place them, you know, in ways that at least look somewhat aesthetically pleasing. And so we'll place it on this line right there. And we're going to get a hound attack. Too bad this isn't up. Once this is up, hound attacks will be no issue. All right, there go all our flingos. I am gonna probably head over to the beefs for one last time. In fact, there's this little herd up here. I'm thinking I might want to try and actually kill them because they're kind of getting annoying. Plus, I want a beefalo hat. And some of them are still in heat. You can tell by their little red butt. And some of them are not. You can tell by their distinct lack of red butt. But, yeah, if it comes down to it, I can fight these hounds, but it's just a little bit easier to let the beefs do it, especially if a few of them are in heat. And I may get and the other reason is because I may get a beefalo to get kilt. That's a kilt, that's a Scottish dress thing that men wear, kilt. But I may get some of them to be killed. And if I do, if I get some of the beefalo to be killed, I may be able to get a beefalo horn, which will in turn let me make a beefalo hat. So I think in general, I'm going to be trying to thin out this herd and kill it because there are plenty of other herds in the neighborhood. Come here, dude. Oh, no. Everybody ran off. You know what? And I'd really like to. Okay, good. They're all running away. I'll take the spoils of war while I may. And they're, yeah, it seems like they're kind of migrating that way. I'm gonna grab this morsel too, just for fun. All right, so our fire farm is ready to be planted. So we will need some boards, and we'll need basically I'm gonna put 2 pig houses in the middle of all of this, and later we may switch out one of the pig houses for a bunny hut. But right now we need 8. Well, okay, let's, before we go crazy, let's drop our hound's teeth off. We'll get 8 pig skin, and I will take my let's see. I'll drop off my, where's my turf chest? Drop off my turf, just so that I have room. We can also drop off our gears. And just checking to make sure there's anything else I could drop off. That all looks good. We'll take our stone, and did we not have a whole bunch of wood? Oh, this is where our wood went. I think 8 boards, if I have calculated correctly. I'm gonna not combine these monster meat because this is real fresh. I'm gonna take these and cook them though. Use a log. Glommer, I like you being close to the fire, bud, but just not that close. At least not right now. All right, we'll cook these up, and just to get some eggs. And anytime you see any meat starting to spoil, you can always cook it, and it will give it a little bit of a new lease on life. It will rejuvenate it. But, and so basically, you can live off of just purely monster meat if you have a bird cage. And the cooked meat will also spoil less quickly than the raw meat. So we'll do 1 monster meat, our almost rotten morsel, and 2 eggs, our almost rotten morsel. There we go. And then in here we'll do meat, monster meat, 2 eggs. Meat, monster meat, 2 eggs. And meat, monster meat, and 2 eggs. That'll give us a bunch of bacon and eggs. Oh, our ice can go back in here until we build our summer flingo. We've only got 1 more flingo that we need to make anytime soon. I guess I could put the stale leafy meat in there. This fleshy bulb, they can be useful as a trash can. They can be useful for a lot of things, actually. But for right now, I'm just going to use it as a trash can. So I will go ahead and plant it down here. And at some point, we may put some turf around it or something so only the eyeballs can grow. But if we need to throw anything away or just destroy it or get rid of it, something that we can't burn, we can take it down there, feed it to the lure plant, and have it out of the out of our base, out of cluttering things up. All right, so back to the task at hand. We need 8 boards. Let me just quadruple check my math here. Yeah, 4 boards. So we need 8 boards and 6 cut stone. Excuse me while I scratch my arm. I just had a mosquito or something. Let's see. All right. So 8 boards and 6 cut stone. What did I do with all that wood? I thought I picked up a lot. All right. Nope. Refine. 5, 6, 7, 8. And 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then in here, I guess this was our log chest. And this can be our kind of rock centered chest. And then we can go ahead, we'll pre-make our pig house just because we can. It's not raining. I'll put on the tam and the walking cane and get my lanthorn out. And I probably need to go pick some more light bulbs and place some more lanterns around at some point. Maybe while I do that, I can go get the bunny houses as well. All right, so right in the middle of this, we would like to place 2 pig house as... All right, it's right in the middle of... Okay, good. I think I placed the flingo as well. Why will it not let me place there? I don't know. Because I would like to place it. I guess there is fine. And then we'll make another one and we'll place it right next to it. This is going to be off-centered a little bit, but that's okay. It looks all right for now. And then we are going to start building hay walls. So this is, let's see. 4 from the edge. And yeah, I'm just gonna place walls in. Nope. That's the hard part of this. It's hard to not hit the repair button. But get that off. I'll probably cut some of this out and just show you the end result because I'm gonna make a whole bunch of hay walls and plant them all around. And maybe I will cut some of that out, but you basically just go through and make sure you're not hitting repair and build walls. It may take the better part of a day or two to do them all, but we're gonna build all of these walls, and I'm gonna build them in rows, kind of, so that it's somewhat easy to get yourself sort of locked in, especially when you start placing them in the little nooks and crannies around the pig house. Oh, I see. I just repaired one that I didn't mean to. And I also built one out here that I didn't mean to. That is okay. We will fix it someday. And I don't think this has to be 100% perfect. But I like to get it as close as I can. And as you can see, we've already gone through a lot of walls and we're... maybe a quarter of the way done. Now sometimes there's something here that it does not want me to plant on. So I'm just gonna, I guess, believe whatever it tells me. And if that hole causes this whole thing not to work, no, don't repair it. If that hole where it won't let me build causes this whole thing not to work, then I guess that's just too bad. We've all learned a valuable lesson. Alright, so as night falls on day 48, you can see kind of what I've done here. I accidentally repaired this one, that's why it's double high. I'm not quite finished with it, but I am almost out of grass. I've got 8 grass left. Oh crap. Turn on the flingos. I may have to save scum this, because I did not put a lightning rod in here and it's storming. But I guess we get a trial by literal fire to see if our flingo will work, if our fire farm will work here. As you can see, the pigs come out of their house repeatedly. Okay, there's not enough grass walls. I lost a few grass walls in that storm. I'm gonna leave these flingos on for now because I lost so much of my grass. As you can see, we got quite a bit. We only ran it for a second, but I'm gonna leave those flingos on. The point of it is it continuously spawns pigs, basically. And the fire kills them, and the flingo will never let things burn up. The flingos will never let things burn up completely, but it's basically an endless kind of meat farm. So we'll stick that meat in there, and I guess we're gonna be going to gather some more grass today. So we are dry. I've got a bunch of ashes from burning that stuff down. We'll stick them in there. Stick our pig skin in here, and we're off to. Let's see. I'm gonna want to keep. We'll keep a full stack of twigs, but I'm gonna want to put that in there. Wait, this is our rock. Let's see. I've forgotten how I've organized this stuff. Okay, this is our basic resources chest. I do want to keep a grass and a twig in there. I'm gonna stick these twigs in there. So this is our wood or plant-based basic resources chest. This is our rock-based basic resources. So anyways, we do have lots of grass around, but I am gonna go over yonder and actually dig up quite a bit of that grass. So, and in order to do that, I'm gonna take a couple of gold, and it's not raining anymore. And we'll go ahead and do our, what am I looking for? Yes, our shovel, because we're gonna be digging up lots of grass. And then my tame enchanter, you know what? I may as well go ahead and make a sewing kit. Oh, I need a prototype. Make a sewing kit and we'll repair our tam. Oh wow, that, I wonder if they changed that. That only does like 20% per or something. Let's see, we'll stick that in our miscellaneous chest for now. And let's see, did we ham's tooth. Okay. All right, I'm off to harvest some grass over here. All right, sorry about that. I'm going to dig a bunch of grass, and you know what, might as well gather poop while we're on our way. Are you guys in heat? Nah, it looks like you guys are okay. We're going to go over here and dig some grass as quickly as we can, because it's almost day 50. Wow, we are quickly running out of days to do things before summer hits. And I really, oh, there's more beefalo over here. Man, I think our world spawn was really good. I mean, it doesn't have a tentacle set piece, a tentacle trap set piece, which is usually a pretty great thing to get. But other than that, the layout and the way we got, you know, just kind of a good... Oh, nope. You are angry. You are angry, sir. Oh, will you follow me away? Because I want to kill you. No. The way that our base setup and everything is kind of... It's like Beefalo, Swamp, Pig King. Like, everything seems relatively close to each other. And I'm not exactly sure. I'm gonna go ahead and dig until I have 20 tufts, and we'll see how well that does for our for our farm. We may not plant them until next fall. But, yeah, as soon as we get this fire farm up, we'll go try and kill Moose Goose real quick. And harvest our wood. And, I mean, honestly, we've got our flingos made. Part of me wants to just stop and go start getting a summer base together. But I think I will attempt to finish what I have started here. And heck, I might as well get 30 while I'm here. But yeah, let's see, what day does summer start on? 54? 52 maybe even? Ooh, I don't know if you can hear that. There's pretty severe thunderstorm going on where I live right now, and the thunder just kind of shook the house. But, yeah, once we get enough grass, should be good to finish our fire farm and get enough food to really sustain us with no problems over the summer. But in hindsight, I probably should have, and we'll just pick one more grass to get a full stack, which may not be enough for a fire farm, but it's gonna have to do for now because I really do need to get the show on the road and get this summer base up and running. Our trees should be fully mature by now, so I think first thing in the morning I will go and attempt to check them out. But we'll get the rest of these. These hay walls placed. Let's see. Basically use almost all our grass to do this. We get one full stack of 20. And yep, I'm just doing the same thing. Just kind of trying to put hay walls in this entire area. All right, we had exactly enough to kind of finish off what I wanted to finish. We'll turn off one flingo and maybe two, and we'll see how badly it burns. And then we'll make a torch. And we'll go ahead and test out our fire farm here. So that should all burn, and the flingos should keep the houses and the loot that's going to be in there from burning up. And we'll just let this run. We are getting pretty low on food, so I'm going to need to go ahead and head back home. It's also starting to rain, so lightning is happening. And I don't want to leave these flingos on, because they will obviously drain the fuel from them. So if I turn on three, it does not go out. And if I turn on the fourth one, this should put it out eventually, even when it's not raining. Or I've made it too big, and I'm gonna need to put another flingo in here somewhere. But this should put out the fire. Hello, this fire should go out. I'm gonna go make some food. And just let them... Oh, there it goes. Good. I have enough hunger left. I'm going to go ahead and collect all the meats, because the pigs will eat it. And like I said, you get kind of a 50-50 pig skin meat drop chance from the pigs. But, yeah, he just ate, I think, a pig skin or something. But as you can see from just running it that long, we got 24 regular meat, and I'm going to actually eat a raw meat right now. It's not going to be super good for me, but sometimes that's what you got to do to survive. Glommer goop, you can go in the burn bag. And this amount of meat is why we need to get working and cracking on things like the... Where's our bacon and eggs? We need to get cracking on things like the drying racks. But first thing is last. Let's drop off our grass tufts. Probably not to be planted until... And I'm a little paranoid about lightning right now, so I'm gonna go ahead and make a couple more lightning rods, one for down there by my farms, and one for my fire farm. So we're gonna go ahead and refine two cut stone. We already had one pre-made. Okay, so we only need one cut stone. That's great. And rocks and gold can go in there, but we will take, let's see, we actually need 8 gold. And, oh no, I'm right. I already have one pre-made. I only need to make one. Okay, so let's take the one that we have pre-made that I apparently never remembered to plant. And I would like to put it, I think if I put it down here, it will cover, my base will be covered. These might be a little too far away. I'm gonna risk it. And then we'll make another one, and of course take it over to our fire farm. Because even though it's supposed to be on fire, I don't want it catching on fire when I'm not here, basically. And I've done a bad thing and placed my I've made this not really super symmetrical, but that's okay. Turn you off, and the great thing is when the hounds come, I can just come over here, turn on two fling-o-matics, and the hound and run around this in circles. Hounds will burn. So now we need to head up real quick before we end this episode. We need to head up here, check out our trees, and possibly take out Moose Goose. But I'm gonna need to prepare for that. Okay, in the morning, well, overnight we'll head up there. And hopefully in the morning we'll be able to take care of all that. So let's go ahead and drop off our manure. Let's pick up our old bell. Let's pick up a fresh football helmet. And we got a log suit. That's fine. Drop off our shove. And our pitch. We got some grass and twigs. And then... Oh, I need a hammer. I need a hammer as well. I am going to also actually need that shovel. Take that bacon and eggs. And you know what? We're just going to take this one with us as well. Let's see. So I need the hammer. And I shouldn't need the shovel or the axe. If the old bell works the way that it should. But I'm not 100% guaranteeing that it will, because I've done this before in the past, and sometimes it seems to be a little tricky. But we'll certainly try it. So the general plan is hopefully she's laid an egg. If she hasn't, I'll probably go ahead and kill her anyways, just because I'm kind of sick of waiting. And the luxury fan is really nice, and you can farm her eggs, which kill her moselings the way that I'm gonna do it, for down feathers, which you use to make the luxury fan, which you use to keep yourself cool in summer. That's really the main reason I'm doing all of this, is to get the luxury fan. And you know, just the loot, but it's not, I don't know if it's important enough to me to just continue waiting or let Moose Goose continue to live. So we'll probably go ahead and murder her come morning. But I can't imagine she has not laid an egg yet. There's gotta be an egg around here somewhere. There's not one down here. It looks like she's walking over that way. I bet it's up above her, up north here. There's got to be an egg somewhere around here. Okay, she has decided to apparently not lay an egg. this season, which is odd. But we'll go ahead and kill her anyways in the morning. But these trees should be ripe for the chopping here, and they are. So what I'm gonna do is, I'll turn on my lantern. I'll stand as close to him as I can. I'll ring the old bell, and I'll wait for the first stomp right there, and then I'll run away. And I wish you could see it, but boom, a big giant foot, and sometimes you get lucky and sometimes you get unlucky, but it's chopped all our wood for us. Yay! So now we have a whole bunch of pine cones to replant, and we've got just a plethora of wood. So I'm gonna go ahead and pick up all of this wood, and I will probably edit that part out because, I mean, come on, that's just ridiculous. But tomorrow in the morning after I've picked up all of this, we will certainly kill a moose goose. But anyways, that's the fruit of our labor for our wood farm, and we're gonna get literally hundreds of wood from doing that. And tons of pine cones that we can then just redo that same exact trick with. Okay, it does not... I thought it dug up the stumps when it stomped down too, so I'm gonna have to go ahead and dig up these stumps manually, but that's no big deal. Anyways, I'll cut back after all this is done. All right, well, my inventory is full, as one would probably expect. I'm gonna drop a few stacks of logs on the ground here. As you can see, we did get a tree guard from all of that. I'll drop the pine cones as well. And we'll go back home, clear out our inventory, and come back up here. I'm just gonna leave an axe and a golden shovel up here. Just in case, as this is my little wood harvesting region. But now, as promised, we will... We'll go take on moose goose. So, in general, to be safe, it's a two-hit kite. To be bold, it's a three-hit kite. And if I were more confident in switching my weapons via the menu and controlling my movement at the same time, or switching my weapons via the little numbers on my keyboard, I would do that. But I'm not confident at that. So I'm just going to do it the old-fashioned way, and we may only get two hits. Moose goose, do not tell me you despawned. Okay, she didn't. We're going to get wet during this, but, you know, not much we can do. She's going to get mad. She's going to swipe at us. We're going to go in for 1-2, run away. Might go in for 3, 1-2-3, run away. 1-2-3, and rinse and repeat. And she honks like that sometimes and blows your weapon out of your hand. You just gotta bait another attack and continue. If you feel like you didn't get a good timing in, you can only do 2. That's fine. But 3 seems to be... Oh, no, don't punch her! Whoops, I hit the wrong button there. Whoop. 1-2-3. My hope is that my tentacle spike lasts for long enough, and she'll honk, we'll pick it up, she'll attack. Pick it up. I think I'm getting hounds again. I am getting hounds again. All right, I'm getting hounds again. I don't know if they will draw aggro onto her, but I'm gonna have to deal with her. I'm gonna have to deal with her later and get these hounds out of here. I'm gonna go ahead and head down to... I guess I'm gonna go ahead and head down to the beefs. That was just kind of an unfortunate. Normally, I feel like I can deal with the moose goose or the hounds. I could probably sync up 4 hounds and deal with them, but I can't do that and deal with moose goose. So I'm just gonna leave our backpack behind there. Our tentacle spike is not amazing. We may... I'm not sure how close she is to dead. I think she's almost dead. But, alright. This hound seems to be... Well... Pigs are not going to be out. Eat your brother. Alright, there's probably still a couple more hounds out here. I'm fairly confident that my, let's keep from getting a little bit wet. That's gonna, see how all our stuff's starting to get wet now? That's gonna start affecting our sanity. Alright. With all of our stuff wet. Also, our lantern is out of stuff, so hopefully we can kill Moose Goose in the rest of the afternoon that we have left. Yeah, I'm not too worried about my sanity. Nightmare monsters are no big deal unless you're also fighting Moose Goose at the same time. And Moose Goose, luckily Moose Goose is super easy, as you saw, to just kite and deal with. But I would like to kill her before the nighttime sets in, just because my torches don't last as long in, here she goes. Come here, lady. Swipe at me. Oh, or honk at me. And we're back into the fray. Yeah, three is fine. I say, yeah. Yeah, there we go. That's a dead Moose Goose. No problem. A little bit of a delay and a detour, I suppose, as it were. Let's put our tam back on and our walking cane. But we did get... See, we only got three down feathers, and I believe we need one more than that. And I really wish she would have laid her egg. So we won't be able to make the... we won't be able to make the weather... Not the weather paint. Well, we won't be able to make that either, but... We won't be able to make the luxury fan. Luxury fan. This year. But that's all right, I suppose. Sanity's still going down. When you see these things in your inventory have blue outlines around them, that means they're wet, and wearing wet clothing really does drain your sanity pretty quickly. As you can see, I'm wearing the Tam O'Shanter, which should be, if not making my sanity go up, at least keeping it stable, and it's not. I do have some room in my inventory. I'm a little bit insane, but I'm also right over here. Well, I'm right by my base. I'll go drop off all the crap. I'm getting a little hungry. We're going to eat up. I'll go ahead and drop off all the crap, and then I guess we will go. We'll go get some more light bulbs, and I'll make a lot more lanterns for my area. To do the lantern glitch, but as you can see, we got meat coming out of our ears, and that's all of that. And we're gonna need more chests relatively soon. We'll put the down feathers in there. Go ahead and stick our logs in here, along with our pink. And we got away with 21%. That's fine. We'll stick more logs in there. Our old bell can go back in here for next time we want to farm some lawagas. And I'm just checking my inventory. We don't need our hammer. And yeah, I think that is going to... That's going to do it for this episode. That was Moose Goose and the tree farm. We'll kind of collect our rewards and start on our summer base next time. Until then, my name is Rantry. Thanks for watching.